Hello, yes. Myself, Dr. Radhika, working as Associate Professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, SRKR Engineering College, Bhimavaram. Today, in this session, I am going to explain about sum of subsets and I am going to explain the algorithm for the sum of subsets problem. So today we are going to discuss about sum of subsets using backtracking. So first of all we will see what is meant by this problem, that is the problem definition. So here you will have n distinct positive numbers, n distinct positive numbers. So that means these are, we call these positive numbers as usually weights. So depending upon the problem, just we are saying it as positive numbers, but usually we call this as weights. So what is the problem is you have to find subsets whose sum is m. So here you will be given m, here you will be given m. So m is what? So it is your, that is here you have to find. So here you have to find all subsets. You have to find all subsets whose sum is m. Whose sum is m. So that means suppose if you have sum n is equal to 4. If you have n is equal to 4. And your weights are, for example, 11, 13, 24, 7. So, these are your weights. And your m is equal to 31. So, this is the problem that is given. You have n distinct positive numbers. So, these are called as weights. And your m is 31. So, what is the problem is, you have to find all the subsets of your W, all the subsets of your W such that the sum of the elements of your subset is equal to 31. So that means what? Suppose if you have n is equal to 4 means how many subsets you will have? You will have 2 power 4. That is you will have totally 16 subsets. You will have totally 16 subsets. Like first one is null. Empty set, and the second one is with one element. So like this you will have one element sets, and then you will have two element sets, and then you will have three element sets, and finally you will have the last one is four elements set. So like this totally you will have how many subsets? Totally you will have 16 subsets. So out of these 16 subsets, for each and every subset you have to find the sum. So for example, if you take 11 plus 13, it is how much? The sum of subsets is how much? This subset is how much? It is 24. So, and for example, if you take this one, for this one it will be 11, and for this one it is 24 plus 24 means 48. So like this, out of all the subsets you have to find the subset which is having the sum as 31. So for this problem, you will get two solutions. Two solutions. What are those solutions is? One is 24, 7. This is one subset. And another one is 11, 13, 7. So you to have two solutions for this subset. So these are the two solutions, and you should find the solutions like this. That means, so this is what fixed tuple variation. This is variable tuple variation. Variable tuple form. And suppose if you want to specify these two solutions in fixed tuple means, you will specify it as 0, 0, 1, 1. So this is one solution and another solution is 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1. So this is fixed tuple solution. And so how you can give the solution in two different forms? One is variable tuple form. You can use anything. So here you can give either solution like this or this. So this is what is meant by sum of subsets problem. So here the bounding function that you will use is, so for k, for example, if you take k, so we say that b of k x1 to xk is equal to true if and only if sigma of I is equal to 1 to k wi xi plus sigma of I is equal to k plus 1 to n wi is greater than or equal to n. And this is equal to false. This is equal to false if and only if sigma of I is equal to 1 to k wi xi plus sigma I is equal to k plus 1 to n wi is less than n. So these are the bounding function that we will be using. This is the bounding function. So using this bounding function, so you will decide whether to go to that particular, whether to expand in that particular path or not. So first, whenever if you want to get the solution for this problem, so first of all, what we have to do is the weights must be arranged in, the weights are arranged in non-decreasing order. In non-decreasing order. And also that means you will give it as W1 less than or equal to W2 less than or equal to W3, so on like this, less than or equal to Wn. And you will use this bounding function. And also what you will say is, so first we should also check whether W1 is less than or equal to m. And also we should check W1 plus W2 plus so on. So if the sum of all the weights is greater than or equal to m, then only you will get the solution for this problem. So this is how you can check. These are the constraints that you have to follow for getting the solution for your problem. So this is what is meant by sum of subsets. So why we are checking this k plus 1 is, so suppose if the elements are arranged in decreasing order, non-decreasing order, so then suppose if you have added the kth object, already the decision for k objects has been taken. Suppose if you are adding the k plus 1th object, so this will be So definitely, so this will be greater than this one. So then what happens? So by adding the k plus 1th object, so even though if you didn't get the solution for the decision up to k, so then it is that means it is waste in going in that path. So then what you will do? Just you will kill that path and you will choose another path. That means you will kill that path and you will backtrack and again you will choose another path for getting the solution. So by using the backtracking you can get. So how many solutions are there for your problem? All the solutions you can get the different solutions for your problem. So this is what is meant by sum of subsets problem. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe to our channel.